Happy Sabbath, children. Happy day. Welcome to this wonderful Sabbath morning. As we're going to begin our Sabbath school program, we call upon Bradley to pray with us.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy day.
Happy day.
Happy Sabbath.
Let's pray. Oh God, we come before you at this time of the Sabbath morning, thanking you for being with us throughout the whole night. I pray that you may be with us during this children's program. Help us learn and understand everything that is going to be taught, Father. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Hello, children. It's another Sabbath. I'm so happy to see this day. We're still missing you. We hope that Corona will end soon for us to come together again and read the stories of God. So today we're going to do our lesson number 5. Last time we learned about He is alive. And today we're going to talk about, do you love me? When you're at home, can you ask your parent, do you love me, mom or dad or aunt or grandma or grandpa? So, have you ever asked someone a question and you repeat the question each and every time, and in your mind you're thinking of, this person, he has not listened to what I'm telling him, because you answer the question each and every time like, do you love me? Yes, I do. Do you love me? Yes, I do. Like, you ask that question more than 3 times and you're like, this person is joking around with me, or what is going on? It's something, has something gone amiss somewhere? So it was after a long time after Jesus had resurrected and the disciples had not yet seen Jesus. And Peter told the other disciples that we are going to the lake for us in order for us to fish. But Peter was uncomfortable because he knew that he denied Jesus. We know the story that Peter denied Jesus 3 times. But Jesus had not shared that story with the other disciples, or the other disciples never knew that Peter had denied Jesus. So as they were fishing, they fished for a very long time, but they never caught fish. Jesus hadn't mentioned that Peter had denied him 3 times. So Peter was still in a dilemma. Should he be happy, or has Jesus forgiven him? Or he was not sure of how to behave among the other disciples. So when they were fishing, they saw a man standing at the shore. And at this shore, that man waved at them, because now they were tired and they were saying, now let us go home. So the man told them, have you catched any fish yet? And they were like, no, we've been fishing throughout. We've not catched anything. Peter then told the disciples, but who is that who is telling us, have we caught any fish? So the man told them, throw the net on the right side of the boat and you'll catch some fish. The man threw, the disciples threw the net and they caught a lot of fish. And this fish, they could not even be able to carry it. Suddenly, John recognized the man and called to Peter. It is the Lord. They were so shocked. They never expected to see Jesus there. But, John was able to recognize the Lord. Peter was so happy to see Jesus again. But in mind, remember that Peter is in a big dilemma if to be happy, because he doesn't know if Jesus has forgiven him. So Jesus was waiting for them. The boat was very close to the shore, so Peter decided not to wait. Because of that anxiety that Peter had, he ran to Jesus first. He jumped out of the boat and hurried through the water to Jesus. The others followed in the boat. So Peter rushed there in order for him to ask maybe, have you forgiven me, or something to make his soul get clear. The others followed in the boat. When they reached the shore, they found that Jesus had made a fire. Jesus had already prepared a fire and where they will burn fish in order for them to take for breakfast. They enjoyed the fish and some bread. After breakfast, now this is where the story gets sweeter. Jesus turned to Peter and asked him for the first time, do you truly love me more than this? And Peter got confused about that question. But he answered, yes, in hurried, because he really wanted to tell Jesus how much he loves him. And he thought him saying that, yes, I love you, he will be forgiven. Or maybe that was the way to make his soul get free. So Jesus looked into Peter's eyes and said quietly, feed my lambs. But in our mind, we know that when Jesus is telling Peter to feed my lambs, it is not the normal lambs that we see. He's telling them, feed my lambs, meaning you go taking more believers each and every day and making sure that you're telling them the truth. So, and Jesus asked again, Peter, do you truly love me? And now this got Peter uncomfortable. And he was like, no, what should I do now? I'll answer the question again. Yes, I love you. Definitely all of us loved Christ. So Jesus replied, take care of my sheep. Remember the first time he told Peter, feed my lambs. Right now he's telling Peter, take care of my sheep. And the third time Jesus asked, Peter, do you love me? And now Peter got even more confused. You're repeating the same question each and every time, and I've answered. Why are you even repeating it? But he couldn't ask Jesus that way because he knew that he was in the wrong side, and Jesus has never shared to the disciples that Peter denied him. Peter did not know what to think. Perhaps he wondered if Jesus didn't believe him, and why did Jesus ask three times? Was it because Peter had denied Jesus three times? So these all questions were running through Peter's mind. And you know, Peter in his mind is saying, you Jesus, you know everything. Even before I denied you, you told me you will deny me. Now, right now, if I'm telling you, I tell you I love you, you're still asking the same question. Why? You're still the same Lord who knows everything. Why are you even asking me that you love me? So with a heavy heart, Peter answered, Lord, you know all the things. You know that I love you. Because now this question has been too much to Peter. So he decided to tell Jesus, you know everything. Like, why should I tell you that I love you each and every time? So take care of my sheep. That was the final statement that Jesus told Peter. The first time he told them, feed my lambs. The second time, take care of my sheep. The third time, take care of my sheep. And now this entered into Peter's mind, and he started believing that Peter is supposed to go to all people and preach this word that God forgives. Because after that, he realized that indeed, it's like Jesus has already forgiven me. Why did Jesus ask Peter these questions in front of the other disciples? So they will know that he had forgiven Peter. In the mind of Peter, he knew that Jesus asked him this way for the disciples to understand that Jesus forgave Peter a long time ago. Even after he denied him, he still took him as his disciple. Jesus also wanted to teach Peter a lesson of patience, sympathy, and forgiveness. Number one, Peter really was disturbed that he has not been forgiven by Jesus Christ. But you know what? Jesus had forgiven him a long time ago. And this, the patience that Peter should have is, when Jesus asked those questions, he had a strong, important point to pass through Peter, that he should always carry his cross and go to people and preach the word of the Lord. He would lead and care for many new believers of Jesus during the rest of his life. Now he was obligated for this work, that every now and then he should go spreading the gospel. It was a duty that he was given, and he was supposed to go according to it. Jesus also wanted us to know something special. There is only one thing we must do to follow and serve him. Love him with all your heart, and everything will be at your doorstep. So when you're at home, those friends that you have at your home, make sure you love them with all your heart. These friends are the people who will help you when you're in problems, and come together, pray to this Lord. Let every friend of yours know that Lord is there. You're there to serve the Lord. Forgive 70 times, 7 times. You don't have to count how many times you forgive, but you're supposed to forgive for your soul to be free, in order for you, when you're spreading the gospel, to spread the gospel in the right way. So our message will be, we serve God when we take care of others. If you're serve God in many different ways. You don't have to preach the Bible in order for us to see that you're serving God. You don't have to come to church every day in order for us to see that you're serving God. But when you take care of each and every person around you, then you'll be serving God. And God will always be happy with you. Show him love with all your heart. And our Bible verse will be coming from the book of John 21, verse 16. And it says, again, Jesus said, do you love me? Take care of my sheep. So if you love Jesus, you'll be able to love your neighbor. You'll be able to love your parents. You'll be able to love your brothers and sisters without you having hatred into your hearts. Be blessed, children. And as at your home, ask your mom to write down songs for you that talk about the love of Jesus, like baby Jesus, the way he was born, and he was born with a lot of love. We have many songs to teach us how we are supposed to be loved and how we are supposed to love our neighbors. Till next Sabbath, God bless you all. Let us pray. Our Almighty Father, who art in heaven, we thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for the children that you've given unto us, Lord. For every step that we make in life, O Lord, may it be according to thy will. Be with us now and forevermore. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I do pray, trust and believe. Amen.
Baby Jesus, I love you, I love you. You are my Savior, you are my Savior. Every day, mtoto Yesu, mtoto Yesu, nampenda, nampenda, wewe ni mokozi, wewe ni mokozi, wa kila siku, who is Jesus? Who is Jesus, Son of God, Son of God, born to be a Savior, born to be a Savior, every day, baby Moses, floating on, in the river Nile, God is watching all the night.
So be careful, little eyes, what you see.
Oh, that Father up above is watching over you. So be careful, little eyes, what you see. So be careful, little nose, what you smell. So be careful, little nose, what you smell. For our Father up above is watching over you. So be careful, little nose, what you smell.
So be careful, little mouth, what you talk.
So be careful, little mouth, what you talk. For the Father up above is watching over you. So be careful, little mouth, what you talk. So be careful, little ears, what you hear. So be careful, little ears, what you hear. For the Father up above is watching over you. So be careful, little ears, what you hear. So be careful, little hands, what you touch. So be careful, little hands, what you touch. For the Father up above is watching over you. So be careful, little hands, what you touch. So be careful, little legs, where you walk. So be careful, little legs, where you walk. For the Father up above is watching over you. So be careful, little legs, where you walk.
When the cross goes, hallelujah,
it's time to me to pray. Before the sun shines bright, when the cock-a-lulu, it's time to pray with daddy. Cock-a-lulu, before the sun shines bright, when the cock-a-lulu, it's time to pray with mommy. Cock-a-lulu, before the sun shines bright, when the cock crows, cock-a-lulu, it's time to pray with auntie. Cock-a-lulu, before the sun shines bright, when the cock crows, cock-a-lulu, it's time to pray with Nako. Cock-a-lulu, before the sun shines bright,
when the cock crows,
cock-a-lulu, it's time to pray with grandma. Cock-a-lulu,
before the sun shines bright. When the cock crows cock-a-doodle-doo, it's time to pray with grandma. Cock-a-doodle-doo, before the sun shines bright. Look at me, I'm just a little boy. I play. For God created me. Look at me, I'm just a little girl. I smile. For God created me, fish. Look at me, I'm just a little fish. I swim. For God created me.
Frog.
Look at me, I'm just a little frog.
I hope.
For God created me.
Hello, children. My name is Lavin Muma. I'm going to tell you the children's story. I'll first pray. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your care. May you give us strength and understanding this story. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Today we are going to learn about Asher and the bones. Asher lived in the town of Tanganyika, and her parents had the job of catching fish in Lake Tanganyika. When their daily meal was eating fish, Asher ate fish every day, and she was tired of eating fish. One day she told her father that when she eat fish, she'll have a stomachache. When she eat fish, she'll have a headache. One day she timed her parents the time which she was going. Her parents were going to catch fish in Lake Tanganyika. Then the time which they went, Asha timed her parents and went to the sufuria to look for fish. She found the fish there and ate faster so that her parents cannot find her there. Unfortunately, she was choked. Asha liked singing every day when she wakes up. She likes singing, "Baby Jesus, Baby Jesus, I love you, you are my Savior, every day. When she was choked, she was unable to sing, Baby Jesus, I love you. Then one day her parents, they were asking themselves, why is my baby singing like this? One day Asha told her father that she was very sick. Her father took her to the hospital, and the doctor said that she was choked by the fish. The father asked Asha whether she ate the fish, and Asha said it's true, she ate the fish. Asha was very ashamed. What does this story teach us? It teaches us that we should not lie to our parents. The memory verse is coming from the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 1, and it says, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, for this is the right commandment with the promise." Do you like my story? Yes, we do. Do you like my story? Yes, we do. So don't forget to come again. To come again. Oh, yes, to tell us more. Let's believe and pray. Thank you, Lord, for your care. Thank you for giving us strength and understanding for listening.
Hello, parents. I hope you are doing well at home with our dear children. It's long since we saw one another. We've really missed our children back at home. I hope you are keeping them safe, clean, till the time, God, that we'll want to see one another. My dear parents, I wanted us to share how to take care of our children at home. First, we train our children on how to wash their hands every time with running water. We sanitize our hands properly. We train our children on how to sanitize their hands properly, how to put on the mask. Now, let's see how to put on the mask. We train our children on how to put on the mask, and when they're putting on, we encourage them not to touch where it falls there, our nose. We put our mask like this. So let's train our children always to put on the mask, and we discourage them from going out. Above all, we remember the word of God. We have 100 days of prayer. Let's include our children in this program of 100 days of prayer, so that the time will come back, still we find that our children are doing well. May God bless us as parents, and we keep on encouraging our children at home and to grow strong in faith. May God bless us, dear parents. God bless you.
Hello, children. Hello once again. We thank God for this Sabbath. He has guided us throughout our program. Until next Sabbath, goodbye.